talk to me.
I open the page, they talk to me.
Come on now, brew walk for me.
Urban Gorilla, that sauce on me.
Yeah, I was shot, Pentecost on me.
He the boss man, he got up on that cross for me.
He the boss man, he got up on that cross for me.
He the boss man, he got up on that cross.
Yeah.
I open the page, they talk to me.
Come on now, brew walk for me.
Urban Gorilla, that sauce on me.
Yeah, I was shot, Pentecost on me.
He the boss man, he got up on that cross.
Right? Give me, Salaki, give me that Proverbs 6 and 23 real quick. Because this is what it comes down to, brother. This is the Holy Bible, the King James Version. Right? King James Version. You said what? Well, the people in Britain are the ones that commanded this translation, yes, into the English, right? Because Britain cultivates what language? Cultivates the English language. Because Britain, that's England, right? So read.
This is Proverbs chapter 6, verse 23. For the commandment is a lamp.
Commandment is a lamp, read.
And the law is light.
The light of the world that Christ came is about these laws, statutes, and commandments. You see what I'm saying? So that's what we're supposed to be following, the laws, statutes, and commandments. We're not supposed to be in a Catholic church or a Baptist church. Any of them churches is not teaching us to follow the commandments. They teach for doctrine the commandments of men. Walking in a church and doing the sign of the cross, that's a commandment of men, right? Doing what they call genuflecting, before you sit in that seat, you got to what? You got to kneel, you got to hit the sign of the cross one more time, right? That's how you're supposed to come to Catholic. That's a commandment of men. When are the commandments of God being taught in that church? That's what I want to know. Because I grew up Catholic, right? So I know everything about the Catholic Church. You know what I never learned in the Catholic Church? The commandments of God. I learned about the sacraments. I also learned that the sacraments, somebody made those things up. When did God command those sacraments? That's my thing. If they're of God, why aren't they in this book? Where the sacraments at in the book? Where they at? Give me book, chapter, verse. See. Oh, yeah, you get a picture. You take a picture. But yeah, here's the thing, brother. Those sacraments, they're not scriptural. First communion, that's not in the Bible. Your confirmation, that's not in the Bible. You understand what I'm saying? The only sacrament they can say is biblical is baptism. Other than that, we can't say that we see anything that they do as biblical precept. Go ahead.
This is John chapter 15, verse 10. If you keep my commandments.
See, Christ said something funny. If you keep my commandments, read.
Ye shall abide in my love.
You should abide in the love of Christ. That's what we're supposed to be doing. Abiding in the love of Christ. He said the only way to abide in his love is if you keep his commandments. Read.
Even as I have kept my Father's commandments.
Just like the way Christ kept his Father's commandments, right? He didn't keep the sacraments, the papal bulls, none of that. He kept the commandments. That's what you see, Exodus, Leviticus, Numbers, and Deuteronomy, right? Read.
And abide in his love.
Sit on that. That's what Tommy, we trying to call our people back to abide in the true love of Christ, right? Definitely, but you got the information, all praise to the Most High, right? Precept, read.
This is the book of Leviticus, chapter 17, verse 7. And they shall no more offer their sacrifices unto devil.
That's what's coming. It's going to come a time where so-called blacks and Hispanics are not going to offer their sacrifice to this white Jesus no more, man. Right? It's going to come a time where ain't going to be no damn Jesus piece walking around on a nigga neck. That's going to be done. It's going to come a time. What happened?
Big Pun had the biggest century boys yet.
Ephraim is joined under idols, right? See? Blueface got a whole Caesar boys on the back of his head. You looking at the back of this nigga head, this is just a damn Caesar Borgia on the back of this boy head, man. Right? And then Benjamin Franklin on the other side. Right? You got two. You see that? There's going to come a time when we're not going to offer sacrifice unto idols. No, you ain't going to look up and deify Benjamin Franklin because he's on the highest dollar bill that your damn oppressor has printed. Right? A major oppressor like Benjamin Franklin. You know how much of a freak Benjamin Franklin was? You go on the History Channel, you know about Benjamin Franklin going over there to England and going and participating in all kind of orgies and stuff? That guy was out of his damn mind. And this is the dude that you're going to deify because he on a $100 bill? You people are crazy, man. Our people have lost their damn mind, right? Read that.
After whom they have gone a-whoring.
That's right. That's who our people go a-whoring after in this time. Devils, man. Who's the chief devil our people going a-whoring after? Caesar Bojere, who you think is Jesus Christ. Who you ignorantly believe is Jesus Christ because it's been forced upon your people for 500 years. Read.
This shall be a statue forever.
For what?
Forever.
Forever we shouldn't be doing this. So all you blacks and Hispanics that are doing this are sacrificing to any devil, worshiping and deifying any idol. Guess what? You better repent now. You better repent now, for judgment is coming, man. It's coming rapidly. It's coming fast, like a freight train. All right? You gotta try to dodge that judgment, baby. Read.
This shall be a statute forever unto them throughout their generation.
That's right. This is a commandment for so-called blacks and Hispanics. That we do not do this, that we not set up this idol on our heart. This is not Jesus Christ, man. Jesus es negro no blanco in la Biblia. Okay? That's what the verdad is, man. All right? Jesus es negro no blanco. All right? Jesus es moreno. Like we are, man. Brown skin, man. Right? Read.
This is the book of Deuteronomy chapter 18, verse 13. Thou shalt be perfect with the Lord thy God.
Time. Huh. Yeah, it's like it. Read it one more time.
This is the book of Deuteronomy chapter 18, verse 13. Thou shalt be perfect with the Lord thy God.
So when we go into the commandments, it commands us that we shall be perfect. But then we have these people with this defeatist mentality that go around the earth and say what? Nobody's perfect. We can't be perfect. But we commanded to be, why would we be commanded to do something we can't do? And why would Jesus Christ reiterate it? Read that.
This is the book of Matthew chapter 5, verse 48. Be ye therefore perfect, even as your Father which is in heaven is perfect.
Right. Be ye therefore perfect, even as our Father in heaven. So Christ reiterated this very same commandment, Yahushua. He said, be ye therefore perfect, even as your Father in heaven is perfect. So that's what time it is. It's time for us to present ourselves in perfection. And how do we present ourselves in perfection? Through keeping the laws and having the faith. But that's what our people got a problem with. Give me Exodus 20. That's why I don't want to get off that. We got to see which one of you blacks and Hispanics out here is even keeping the Ten Commandments. We doing a hashtag Ten Commandments challenge. Which one of you blacks and Hispanics out here is keeping even the Ten? Who? Start from the top.
This is the book of Exodus chapter 20 verse 1. And God spake all these words saying, verse 2, I am the Lord thy God which have brought thee out of the land of Egypt.
This is who's speaking to us? Our Lord, our God, whose name in the Hebrew is Yahweh, who brought the ancestors of blacks and Hispanics out of the slavery in Egypt, a hard slavery in Egypt. Read.
Out of the house of bondage. Verse 3. Thou shalt have no other gods before me.
That's the first thing. We shall have no other gods before him. Who is this? Who is this right here? Most of our people either have this in their house, or if they don't have it in their house, you know where they got it at? In their heart. Give me that, the idols in their heart. If it's not in your house, I know where Caesar Borgia, this damn devil, is. He's in your heart. When you think about God, when you think about Jesus, when you pray at night, this is who is in your mind. Why is this in your mind? Because you set up an idol in your heart, right? It's been designed to be the idol in your heart, right? Read.
Verse 4. Thou shalt not make unto thee any graven image or any likeness of anything.
See, the Bible says you shall not make graven image. But y'all just went to the Catholic Church that's full of graven images. It's a whole house of graven images. It looked like a damn haunted house when you go in there, right? Read it again.
This is the book of Exodus chapter 20, verse 4. Thou shalt not make unto thee any graven image or any likeness of anything that is in heaven above, or that is in the earth beneath, and that is in the water under the earth. Verse 5, thou shalt not bow down thyself to them.
You ain't supposed to make this to bow down to and to serve it. You walk like I was explaining with the brother. Soon as you walk in the, before you can sit down in the Catholic Church, you have to bow down to this, to Caesar Borgia. He has to be bowed to. If you can't sit, you got a free go. See what I'm saying? Before you take a seat. What is that? But that's directly against the Bible. Right? So this is how I know our people ain't keeping these commandments. Why? Because everything about the tradition of our religious systems is against the first 10. The first 10. You can't even get past the first 10. Right? Hold that. Give me that.
This is the book of Ezekiel, chapter 14, verse 3. Son of man, these men have set up their idols in their heart.
In what?
In their heart.
See that? Same thing, we in the same position as Ezekiel. We prophets sent out here to prophesy to our people, right? And what do we find when we see our people? That they've set up the idols in their heart. Read on.
And put the stumbling block of their iniquity before their face.
See that? So they making the idol, but first, before they have to fashion the idol, it's set up in their heart. What you really dealing with your mind? It's in their mind already. Right, Reed?
No, a little bit more. Should I be inquired of at all by them?
That's why God said, I don't even want to hear y'all, man. I don't want to hear y'all because all y'all think about is this damn white boy every time you pray to him. So he don't even want to hear what you're talking about. That's why people praying, grandma praying to hit the lotto. You praying to pray, listen, my brother in that coma. Trying to get him, he got shot the other day. I'm trying to get him out that coma. He don't come out that coma, man. Right? Why? Because you not keeping the law, he not keeping the law. Right? All you thinking about is your idol, man. You think you praying. You ain't praying to the Most High. You praying to see the Bojan. He don't want that. He don't want nothing but you to die in the first place. That's what he want. Read. This is the prayer to him. He go, yeah, he's going to kill him. Read.
This is the book of Jeremiah, chapter 15, verse 6. Thou hast forsaken me, saith Yahweh. Thou art going backward. Therefore, I will stretch out my hand against thee.
And that, how will God, is God going to come down here and just have personal conversation with everybody? No. How does he stretch out his hand? This is what we doing. We repeat with my hand stretched out. We out here rebuking you so-called blacks and Hispanics. This is how the Lord stretches his hand out. By setting his prophets up on the streets all over the damn world and having us come out here and rebuke our people, man. Right. It's high time that the so-called black and Hispanic wake up and repent and come back to the fact that they're the Hebrew Israelite of the Bible. And that we need to keep the law, statutes, and commandments. Read.
And I will stretch out my hand against thee and destroy thee. I am weary with repenting.
You see that? The Most High has wearied himself. He said, I just got to destroy these people. These people are as evil as hell. I gave these people everything, man. And what did we do to the Most High? We gave the Most High our proverbial ass to kiss, man. Read.
This is the book. Put your kind. This is the book of Proverbs, chapter 5, verse 11. And thou mourn at the last when thy flesh and thy body are consumed.
That's what's going to be a lot of mourning when it's time for the missiles, when it's time for that judgment, man. All right? You want to keep worshiping this damn white Jesus, man, we will see what that's going to get us. The same thing has got us for 500 years, man, destroyed by that same white Jesus. That same white boy that we bow to. He the same one destroying us. Read.
On verse 12. And say, how have I hated instruction?
Say what?
And how have I hated instruction?
That's what our people are, so-called blacks and Latinos, man. We absolutely hate instruction. The only people's instructions we want to follow is the white man that's been oppressing us and raping, robbing us for 500 years. That's the only instructions we want to follow. We don't want to follow our own instructions. We especially don't want to follow the instructions of the Most High God. We'll only follow instructions for wickedness. That's the only thing we want to follow, man. All right? When are our people going to wake up? That's what I want to know. You so-called blacks and Latinos, when in the hell are you going to wake the hell up, man? That's the true question. It's high time. Give me that. It's high time to wake out of your sleep, man. We got to understand, we got to take a look at all the turmoil that's befalling so-called blacks and Hispanics all over this earth right now. Look at all the conflicts that's going on. Then you go to South America, Central America, the islands, it's conflicts going on. Major conflicts with the people and the governments right now. Why? Venezuela, right? Chile right now, right? Haiti. Mexico, y'all hear when they try to lock up El Chapo, little son? Yeah, listen, man, they wasn't going for that. They gave them people hell behind that little boy, man. They gave them hell. They had to just, listen, we just gonna release him. We ever see the government just release a captain? Oh, no, we just gonna let that nigga out. No bail. He good. He all right. You see what I'm saying? Why? But why them cartels? Hear what people don't understand. You think the cartels are down there beeping about some dope? Dope is nothing. Dope is worth a damn dollar a sack at this point. Why are they killing? You know why the cartels is down there killing each other right now? You know what the number one crop for the cartel is right now? The white folks' guacamole. The white man want to eat guacamole, so the so-called Mexicans getting murdered, man. Killing each other. Because white people like to eat guacamole. See that? They want to eat guacamole with they little chips at Chipotle. So you know what? It's a so-called Mexican got to die for that, man. Multiple of them. Just to get that damn avocado into the... You know how crazy that is? That avocado trade, man, that's bigger than all the dope right now coming out of Mexico is the avocado, right? You said what? You got to pay extra for it. Why? Because people are dying for it. That's why. Because somebody got to die in order for that guacamole, that little bit of guacamole that you get right there. Understand that one of your brothers had to pay with his life for that, right? That's how serious some damn guac, but that's how much they love it. See, back in the days of slavery, that was happening over what? Over sugar. Sugar cane, right? Before it was cocaine, nigga, it was sugar cane, right? Sugar cane was the main thing. And guess what? We was dying over it down there in the islands, man. We was dying for that, man. The so-called Haitian man, Jamaican man, Brazilian man. We was dying behind that. And coffee. See, it's the white man's luck. He want to have the coffee. He want to eat the sugar he never damn had before. He wants some damn guacamole. You have to understand that their want for guacamole and coffee and sugar caused the death of millions of people.